Who needs a superhero? Chapter 1. Saving Superman, saving Sun from above. Part 6. Saving by heart. Now, a classic episode of the television sitcom Seinfeld. Jerry and George argue about the extent of Superman's powers. Jerry insists that Superman's arsenal of power surely includes a super sense of humor. He argues that if Superman has super hearing, super vision, super breath, and then a super sense of humor must follow. George is skeptical. He asserts that Superman's powers are all physical. Super is only skin deep and does not apply to the inner man. The debate is one the comic book writers danced around for decades. One of their favorite ploys was to strip Superman of his more than human abilities temporarily. In the process, they reveal that even a non-Superman is still a hero. For instance, when Superman is depowered and shrunken to doll size by the robotic villain Brainiac, the diminished champion decoys the murderous Brainiac while Lois Lane and Jimmy Olsen escape. When Superman battles the parasite, he fights on even after his powers have been absorbed by his foe. And when Superman visits the city of Kandor, whose atmosphere renders him mortal and vulnerable, the Man of Steel dubs himself Nightwing and adopts a new identity as a costume do-gooder without the help of special powers. Dozens of similar stories depict a humbled Superman who continues to save the weak and defend the underdog. So on this point, George is wrong and Jerry is right, at least in principle. Superman's greatness does extend into the spiritual realm. When invulnerability and super strength are undeniable assets, Superman's heroism is ultimately rooted in his heart, not in his biceps. Yes, if ever a story showed us how heroism is rooted in the heart, it might be Superman. But as I told the woman at that Thanksgiving service, my Superman is found in Jesus, whose supreme act of salvation was accomplished through weakness and in his willingness to bow his head to death. Flying in the face of first century Jewish expectations, Jesus did not arrive at the head of an invincible angelic army. Instead, he was born in a stable, lived in poverty, bore the contempt of Israeli leaders, died in humiliation, and was laid in a borrowed tomb. In the final showdown with evil, he did not rescue us through such superhuman powers. Commanding storms or quelling demons, Jesus saved us by the love of his heart, the love that embraced the cross and entered the tomb for our sake. The similarities between Superman and Jesus are myriad, yet the story of a man who came down from Krypton is the palest shadow of the story of the man who came down from heaven. Laying aside celestial glory, Jesus cast his lot with humanity and joined us in pain and turmoil of human life. He was with us in the first century, and he is here with us still, beside us now and always. Superman's motto is up, up, and away. But perhaps the mission of Jesus is better caught in these words: down, down to stay. Thank God. And that is the end of chapter 1 of Who Needs a Superhero? Superman Saving Sun from Above. Again, thank you for tuning in. I hope you have a great and wonderful day. We will have chapter 2 up hopefully shortly, and so we can get caught up with these readings with the where I am in the actual book on my where I got to through the other podcasts before I started just doing this by itself. Again, remember to like, subscribe, hit that notification button, share, and comment. Have a great and wonderful day.